where you had gone?
I've been out all night searching for her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely?
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that, I must confess. I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here, in the woods.
In the woods?
In a tall tower with no door or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues due east of here, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage your visit?
I stand beneath her tower and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, who ever heard of such a thing? Surely you jest. What kind of a name is that?
I speak the truth. She is as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, the empower of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Life in becoming, frequently humming, a light-hearted air. Agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors.
Agony, all the torture they teach.
Once is intriguing,
or a hassle fatiguing, as
once out of reach.
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, an heir to a throne?
For everything maidens could wish for.
And why not?
And why not?
The girl must be mad.
Nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her.
Agony is real, although it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her. You